20 minutes away at the Brooklyn Bridge, across the street in Jeanette McKinley's apartment, and on top of the high-rise two blocks away.
This is the one that was within 20 minutes of the collapse of the tower. This is a great sample. Thermite is a very active chemical reaction. It produces molten iron spheres. The spheres you get from thermite matches the spheres that I see in the World Trade Center desk.
There is no possible source for these iron-rich microspheres except for an aluminothermic reaction under extremely pressurized conditions.
8 weeks later, we still got fires burning. At one point, I think they were about 2,800 degrees.
The guy's boots just melt within a few hours.
Molten steel running down the channel.
USGS found not only iron-rich, but molybdenum-rich spheres. Now, that speaks to a much higher temperature required for molten molybdenum to form spheres.
We see the residue. This is a smoking gun already, but can we find the gun? I guess you could.
These tiny chips that have the unignited thermite in them.
They're unignited materials. Now, they may also be partially ignited.
This is high-tech stuff, nano-sized particles of iron and aluminum.
Iron, oxygen, aluminum, carbon, silicon, and quite often potassium.
And this is extremely explosive stuff. This stuff is not made in a cave in Afghanistan.
After the red chips are ignited, you have just an abundance of these little iron-rich spheres. They're just beautiful, these little iron-rich spheres, and there's silicon-rich spheres too, which tend to be translucent, and they're beautiful. You know, if nothing else, there's a certain element of beauty, and from a point of view of science, it's exciting. But the implications just start getting sort of depressed, I guess, when you think about what it means to have this high-tech, explosive, thermitic material. There it is, telling you that there is something awful that happened on 9/11.